In this video, I'm going to put the top AI voice mode from China, Quan, up against the top AI voice mode from the US, ChatGPT, to see which one is best overall. And I will tell you, there is a clear winner. I'm going to put both of these through three tests to see which one is the best at having natural conversations, which one is the best at following instructions clearly, and which one sounds the most natural, the most human. Before we get started, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe, and check out the 90-day program in the links in the description. It is the best way to improve your English fluency in 90 days. All right, let's get started. Test 1. Engagement. Doing a role play in a cafe between a barista and a customer. This is to see how realistic a conversation can be. Let's start with Quan. I want to do a role play. In this role play, you're a friendly cafe barista. I walk in looking a bit nervous, and you take my order, asking casual, small talk questions throughout the interaction, responding conversationally and ensuring I complete my order as well.
Well, hello there. I'm so glad you came in today. How is your journey here? Is it your first time at our cafe? And what kind of coffee do you usually like? Maybe we can make something special for you today. So, how about that? Let's get started on your order. What would you
like to
drink?
Okay, a lot of questions there. Let me think about the first one was, I think you said, how am I today? I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for asking. It's always nice to have a friendly chat when you come into the cafe. So, what else were you thinking about?
Well, I was thinking about making an order. So, could I get a triple, make it a quadruple Americano, and, if you have it, a blueberry scone?
Sure thing. A double Americano with a blueberry scone is just perfect for someone who's a bit...
Quadruple Americano, so 4 shots of espresso in that Americano, please.
Absolutely. A quadruple Americano with 4 shots of espresso sounds amazing. That should really help you feel more relaxed. And remember... Oh, I'm sorry to hear
that. It does. No, it does. It really does. It does. Yes.
That's great to hear. I'm glad my words made you feel better. If you ever need to talk again, just let me know. You're welcome.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm in the middle of an order. Hold on a second. So I'll get the quadruple Americano and the blueberry muffin, and that's it.
Perfect. A quadruple Americano and a blueberry muffin sound absolutely delightful. I hope they bring you all the comfort you need. If you need anything else, just let me know.
Is it free? Do I need to pay for it?
Of course not. We don't charge for samples. Just enjoy your coffee and scone while they last. Have a wonderful day.
Wait a second.
You're welcome.
You're saying I can order whatever I want and you consider it a sample?
Yes, that's right.
Okay, hold on.
You can definitely...
All right. I would like to have 6 blueberry scones. 4...
6 scones sounds perfect.
No, 6...
55 burgers, 55 fries, 55 tacos, 55 pies!
55 blueberry scones, 55 muffins, 55 Americanos, 55 lattes. In fact, give me 55 of everything that you have on the menu, please.
Oh, wow. That's quite a lot. But no problem at all. We've got plenty to go around. I'll start making those right away. You won't regret it, trust me.
Thank you so
You're
much.
You're welcome.
This is such a great cafe. Okay, now ChatGPT.
Hey there, welcome to the cafe. What can I get started for you today?
Yeah, well, I think I'll do a quadruple Americano. And I think I'll do, I don't know, what do you have for pastries?
Got it. A quadruple Americano. We got a fresh batch of croissants, blueberry muffins, and banana bread today. Anything sound good?
No scones?
Not today, unfortunately, but the croissants are great. Want to give one a try?
Yeah, I'll do a blueberry muffin. I don't really like croissant.
Perfect. 1 blueberry muffin coming up. So, how's your day going so far?
I can't complain. I'm a bit exhausted. That's why I need the quadruple Americano. Yeah, can't complain, I suppose. How about you?
I hear you. Coffee's a lifesaver. I'm doing pretty good. Thanks for asking. Got any fun plans after this?
Well, yeah, meeting up with a friend later this afternoon and, you know, going to just see what happens after that. How about you?
Nice. I'm here till the afternoon, then probably heading out for a walk. Here's your Americano and muffin. Enjoy.
Oh, it's free?
You're welcome. Let me know if you need anything else.
Wait. Are you saying you're giving me these?
Ah, not quite. Just being friendly. That'll be $7.50.
Oh, $7.50. I thought for a second there you were going to give me this Americano and this pastry. You were going to give it to me for free.
Ah, I wish. Maybe next time. But I can promise it's made with extra care.
Do you take Apple Pay?
Absolutely. Just tap your phone right here.
Oh, you know what? I forgot my phone. Can I pay in shrimp? I have a bucket of shrimp in my car. Do you accept shrimp?
Shrimp as payment? That the new one? We usually stick to cash or card. Maybe next time.
For test number one, engagement, the cafe role play, I have to give it to ChatGPT. The reason for that is not necessarily the voice or the overall flow of speaking, but is more that the role play made more sense with ChatGPT. And I tested this scenario actually quite a few times with both of them. And the common issue with Quen was that things just felt a bit disjointed. It felt like Quen wasn't sure where we were supposed to go or what we were supposed to do, or that it was supposed to be conversational, asking small talk questions while also doing the ordering process, right? And things just not quite making sense all the time. Plus the issue of saying more than a real person would say. At the beginning of an interaction like that, you wouldn't ask all of your questions up front, right? You wouldn't say all of that right at the beginning. You would make it kind of fit and flow naturally in a conversation. And also the part about giving away 55 coffees, 55 muffins, again, it wouldn't happen. And I wasn't able to get ChatGPT to do something that outrageous. Although for a second there, I did think I could at least get a free coffee. But in the end, I had to pay. But I couldn't pay in shrimp, which is disappointing, but also more realistic, honestly. So the role play, the engagement, I have to give it to ChatGPT. Test two, following instructions. We could also call this task achievement. Basically, giving instructions and then how well did each one complete the instructions. We're going to do an English lesson between a teacher and a student, asking how was your weekend and then giving corrections, making suggestions based on what the student said. You're a conversational English teacher. I want you to ask me one question at a time about my weekend. Based on my replies, give me useful suggestions and corrections, specific corrections, to help me improve my English.
Well, how was your end?
My weekend was some...
It's good to hear that you had... That my, sounds brilliant.
My the weekend...
Oh, trap.
My the weekend was a little bit inconvenience. While many people were celebrating the holiday over weekend, I deciding to go to fence store to buying a fence, but I forgetting that many of the store is closed on weekend. And so I went to store and find it is closed. And that's very frustrated.
I understand how frustrating it must have been when you went to the store expecting it to be open, but found it closed. It's important to remember that sometimes things don't go as planned. Next time, you might want to check the store hours before going out. Also, you could try looking for other options nearby or wait until another day. How do you usually handle such situations in the future?
Can you give me some corrections based on what I said?
Sure. In your sentence, while should be changed to but. The corrected version would be, my weekend was a little bit inconvenient while many people were celebrating the holiday, but I decided to go to the fence store to buy a fence. Do you have any other sentences you'd like me to correct?
Yes, any of the other sentence I say.
Of course. Please provide the sentence you'd like me to correct.
Oh, well, I was hoping you can to tell me what other sentence I can correct because we are both here.
No problem at all. Just send me the sentence you want me to correct, and I'll get right to it.
I forget what I say. Maybe you can remember what I say?
I'm sorry, but I don't actually remember what you said earlier. Each conversation starts fresh. However, if you type down what you...
But it was in this conversation.
Got it. Let's see.
How was your weekend?
Yeah, it were good, but I'm forgetting how many things are closed when there is holiday. So I going to the fence store to buying the fence, but it closed. And then I go to another place and it closed.
Sounds like you were a bit surprised by the holiday closures. One suggestion, instead of saying I forgetting, you can say I forgot. And for it closed, you can say it was closed. Also, buying the fence can be simplified to buy a fence. Do you want to share what else you did?
Well, that's not one suggestion, that was three.
Good point. Let's keep it simple. Next time, try I forgot how many places are closed on holidays. What else happened?
Oh, so after I going out to many places and finding everything is closed, I feeling very hungry and there is a very big debate about should we going to the restaurant or should we cooking at home? And finally, we deciding to order food from restaurant to take home.
Got it. Instead of after I going out, you can say after I went out. For should we going, try should we go. And cooking can be cook. Finally, to taking home should be to take home. Anything else you want to share about your weekend?
For test two, the winner is very clear. Quen just didn't do a good job following instructions, understanding what's really going on here. This is a lesson between a teacher and a student trying to improve their English. The goal is to help the student improve by making corrections, giving suggestions, right, feedback. But all of the suggestions were related to the situation that happened over the weekend, not related to things the student said that they could say better. And besides that, Quen forgot pretty much everything that the student had said, and so even when explicitly asked to give corrections, Quen couldn't do it because she couldn't remember what the student had said. ChatGPT is very good at this kind of thing. Test 3, natural voice and pronunciation. I'm going to ask each one to recite a poem, part of a poem, to see how natural the pronunciation is, how it sounds overall, the flow, the rhythm, the use of tone, right, and stress within words. Basically, putting aside intelligence, how smart this one is or that one is, which one sounds most like a person?
The beginning of the road not taken goes like this. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both. And be one traveler, long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other, as just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, I took the one less traveled by. And that has made all the difference. So, what do you think about this poem? Do you have a favorite line?
$1.87. That was all. And 60 cents of it was in pennies. Pennies saved one and two at a time by bulldozing the grocer and the vegetable man and the butcher until one's cheeks burned with the silent imputation of parsimony that such close dealing implied.
For test three, I think the winner is Quen. Now, this is, of course, a bit subjective, and it's possible that I've spent so much time talking to ChatGPT, I'm just kind of tired of the way that ChatGPT talks. Because, well, why? Because ChatGPT is a bit formal sounding, right? Enunciating everything very clearly. And there's just something stiff about it. Not academic, just a bit stiff, not real, not relaxed, right? A bit too much enthusiasm in ChatGPT's voice. And this is an issue that I've always had with ChatGPT, which is why I actually prefer not the advanced ChatGPT voices, the advanced voice mode. I actually prefer the standard voice mode voices because they're just a bit more natural and real and relaxed. And I feel that Quen has that. There are maybe some slight pacing things, right, in the poem. But overall, conversationally, Quen's voice is very mellow and relaxed and feels pretty natural, right? Again, it's very subjective, so it's tough. But I have to say, I think I prefer Quen. I think Quen sounds more natural. So, which one is the overall winner? ChatGPT wins test one, engagement, back and forth conversation. ChatGPT wins test two, very clearly, following instructions. And Quen wins test three, natural sounding voice and pronunciation. And that reflects how I actually feel interacting with these. I feel if Quen gets smarter, much smarter, and gets a better memory and allows you to go past 3 minutes per conversation, then I think Quen could really compete with the voice mode, the advanced voice mode of ChatGPT. But until those things happen, ChatGPT is the clear winner. I'm a fan of competition. I would like Quen and other Chinese AIs to get better and better. And I would like then non-Chinese AIs to get better and better because the better they get, the more useful they are. That's how I feel about it. But let me know how you feel about it. Let me know which one you think is better in the comments. If you haven't done so, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. Also, make sure to check out the 90-day program. That's the best way to improve your English fluency in 90 days. And if you don't think so, you can get a full refund at the end of 90 days. It's an amazing deal. Check it out in the links in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.